Hello everybody, Alex here. Welcome to my friends in the Accounting Education channel here on YouTube. Today we have a more unusual video from multiple perspectives. First of all, I'm going to present two companies in one video. If you follow this channel, you know that I'm interested in REITs, Real Estate Investment Trust, as an alternative to investing in real estate. Basically, you have two alternatives. You can either buy objects, so you buy house, apartments, and so on and so forth, with multiple purposes. Rent income might be one of them, but if you don't have that much money or you don't want to take so much risk with only one apartment or one house and so on and so forth, the alternative is that you have these real estate investment trusts, which are collecting money from more investors and investing it further in real estate. I'm linking right now the video in which we talked about real estate investment trust from France. If you remember, there were several episodes in which I presented all the real estates from real estate investment trusts from three countries, namely France, Germany, and United Kingdom, that are included in the Stock 600. Stock 600 is the European index with the largest companies in Europe, very similar with the S&P 500. And in this video, which I just linked, you can find the presentation of the French Real Estate Investment Trust. And later during this video, I will also link the last video in which I have selected two of the real estates from each country, so two from Germany, two from France, and two from United Kingdom to invest in. For France, they were Gecina and Covivio. I'm already invested in Gecina and Covivio, not yet, but it will happen soon enough as well. And so this would be one point how the presentation for today is interesting, that we are going to present two companies. And the second interesting, okay, their results, let's say results for quarter one. And the second interesting thing is that they do not have an obligation to present results or to have earnings call with the so in the investors relation officially, like other companies. I think it's a requirement from France, but however, because they are listed, they need to present, to have some press releases every quarter in which they present the performance of the company. So it's quite similar with what we are used to, and we are going to do this. But before we jump right in, I'm going to ask you to subscribe my channel, to hit the bell notification button. It doesn't cost you a thing. It will help me a lot. If you hit the bell notification button, you'll never miss an update on my site. I do them quite regularly these days. On Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Sundays, you should expect new and hopefully interesting videos. We start with the one in which I'm already invested. We talk with Gecina, about Gecina. You see, it's a press release from April 21, 2022, so they don't do calls. Normal calls with analysts and so on and so forth. Business at March 31st, 2022, so it's basically quarter one of 2022. Dynamic first quarter with solid operational performances. Gross rental income of 153.3 million, up 2.2 like for like. Occupancy rate up for all asset classes, plus 80 basis points over 3 months to 92%. Rental market upturn with nearly 30,000 square meters of offices let. Positive reversion of plus 18% recorded on offices in the first quarter. Pipelines positive net contribution to rental income. Liability structure ensuring good financial visibility. Target confirmed for recurrent net income per share growth to 5.5 euro in 2022. And then they just go in the occupancy rate across all asset class. So the point they just presented. Significant rental reversion captured in the first quarter, particularly at the heart of Paris. Rental reversion captured still positive with plus 80% of offices in the first quarter, driven by the transactions carried out at the heart of Paris in particular. Upturn in rent indexation. This is why one reason why REITs are considered to be a good investment, especially in the times of high inflation, because they can pass the inflation to the customer, to the customers. For reference, the benchmark index published each quarter for office rent indexation came to 4.3% at end of 2021, whereas it was negative minus 1.2% 1 year earlier. Pipeline positive net contribution to rental income. For the first quarter, the pipeline's net contribution by assets delivered, net of assets launched for redevelopment, was positive. Liability structure adapted and robust, ensuring good financial visibility. Target confirmed for recurrent net income per share growth to €5.5 in 2022. Then they go into gross rental income up 2.2% to 153.3 million. So it's mostly an update in which they are presenting, let's just say, results at March 31st, 2022, compared with 2021. The growth is coming mostly from student residences, which is interesting. But if you take the total gross rental income, it dropped from 158.1 to 153.3. That this is, let's just say, not taking into consideration the new space and the space that they no longer have. If you take it with like, they actually have a growth of 2.2%. The organic performance to plus 2.2% reflects the first effects of the reduction in office and residential vacancy levels and the normalization of activity levels for student residences. The effects of the increase in indexation will be gradually seen over the coming quarters, further strengthening the factors contributing to the upturn in organic rental income growth. Rental income is down 3%, linked primarily to the impact of the office sales completed in 2021. But that you understand, it's not because they had to reduce the rent per square meter, but because they sold some space. Sales completed in 2021. In 2021, Gecina completed or secured 544 million of sales of non-strategic buildings, including Port d'Arcueil in Arcueil, Orion in Montreuil, and Louis Michel in Levallois. In the third quarter of 2021, the value sales completed in 2021 achieved a premium of around 9%, plus 9% versus the end 2020 appraisal values, with the loss of rental income for the first quarter representing 5.4 million. Positive net contribution for the development pipeline. The contribution by the buildings delivered in 2021, primarily the Antos building in Bologna and the Inn of Student Residence in Ivry, came to 1.5 million. Higher than the temporary loss of rent on buildings with strong value creation potential freed up to be redeveloped, minus 4.7 million. And they talk about the occupancy rates. And you see offices, how the occupancy rates is developing. Actually, compared with the last quarter, is growing. Slight growth also in traditional residential and strong growth in student residences. Then they take a look at the offices, so separately and in details, and the development in Paris and other French regions, Paris region, other Western Crescent, La Défense. Yeah, all in all, quite detailed explanations about how the results developed in Q1 2022. Yeah, if you want more details about this company, feel free to read them. It's very easily you can find on the Gecina .fr. You can find more details. I mean, there is a lot of explanation how the things going. Just as I have said, it's not a full financial statement associated with it. They don't have this legal requirement or let's say regulatory requirement from the stock exchange. However, the things don't look very, very bad. They are quite okay, and I mean, it's hard to translate how this will reflect in the financial statements, but I guess for the financial statements we just have to wait a little bit. They are mostly in offices. I think offices also took a beating in the last 2 years of pandemic because of work from home and companies that went potentially bankrupt and so on and so forth. So that would be about Gecina, and moving to the other one, which is Covivium. It's also released on 21st of April 2022. It's like an activity report, activity at end March 2022, strong recovery confirmed in the first quarter of 2022. Office occupancy rate 92.4%. Fresh successes in our development pipeline, stream building and on June 94% and 100% pre-let respectively. Hotel strengthening of the recovery and inaugural brand management transaction in France. Hotels also were affected if we are thinking about it in the past 2 years. Although it's a French company, it has also German residential in portfolio. So. And they have a 183 million in new sales commitments with an average margin of 2% above the latest appraisal values. Covivio continues its corporate social responsibility roadmap and strengthens its team. Carbon trajectory, 26% reduction in our carbon emissions between 2010 and 2021. Continued rollout of the Covivio Foundation, 12 non-profit supported in France, Italy and Germany. The reinforcements of teams appointed of appointment of Frederike Hoberg as new head of the German office business. General meeting approves all resolutions, payment on 27th of April of a cash dividend of 3.75 per share, representing an increase of 4.2%. So, because in the presentation of the rates and when I took the decision, this is basically for rates, that's very important. How much dividends they are paying and if these dividends are increasing, and with an increase of 4.2% and a dividend yield of 5.1%, which is quite a good one. Probably it will increase because the inflation seems to be increasing above this level, so they might need to increase faster the dividends as well. Strong revenue growth at the end of March 2022, plus 7% like for like. Offices plus 2.9% on a like-for-like basis. Germany residential, just as to again to tell what is this like-for-like. They have movements in the portfolio, and in order to see the, let's say, the organic development, you need to take out the things which came new in the quarter, and also the ones which were taken out from the portfolio in the within the quarter. German residential plus 2.9% with plus 3% in North Rhine-Westphalia and 2.6% in Berlin. Hotels plus 51% driven by the recovery in variable rents. 95.2% occupancy rate versus 95% at the end of 2021. Relatively stable. Covivio diversified and continuously adapting portfolio. 26.7 billion portfolio, 7.7 billion group share. 57% of the portfolio comprises offices in France, Italy and Germany, mainly in central locations in Paris, Milan and the main German cities. Germany residential represents 28% of the portfolio, is located in the city centers of Berlin, Dresden, Leipzig and Hamburg and in major cities in North Rhine-Westphalia. Hotels 50% of the portfolio located in major European tourist destinations, Paris, Berlin, Rome, Madrid, Barcelona, London, etc. are led or managed directly by major operators such as Accor Invest, AIHG, BNB, NH Hotels, etc. 41% of the properties in value are located in Germany, 38% in France and 16% in Italy. The portfolio is managed according to three strategic pillars, focusing on location in the heart of major European cities, new building design combining energy performance, well-being and adaptation to changing trends, and customer culture with the user-centric strategy. Covivio supports its clients in their property strategies over the long term by jointly defining their projects and forging sustainable partnerships. Then we have good operating momentum across all businesses. Then they just describe a little bit what's going on in Paris, in six major German cities, in Milan, in Italy. again, a lot of description of what they have done operationally. So variable rent hotels, you have here the evolution per Germany, European Union and France and United Kingdom. Yeah, and Omicron wave, the drops. So it's interesting that they have highlighted it, what happened here. We spoke about already about the customers, corporate social responsibility. Now they are talking also so a little bit in, more in detail about the carbon emissions, about the Covivio Foundation, about the new team members. General meetings approves all resolutions. So basically, they are just now detailing what they have said at the beginning. It's like it was like an executive summary, and now are the details. Then we have revenues. So the share of the group like for like variation, occupancy rates. Hotels in Europe 100% occupancy rates. Quite interesting. Yeah, all in all, a lot of details. The EBITDA of hotels under management contracts, mainly in France and Germany, also improved significantly, plus 69% versus Q1 2021. So the results are quite positive. And here you have some 2022 outlook, which is more interesting. Let's say the economic, monetary, financial, and geopolitical environment has undergone profound changes since the beginning of the year. Inflation has reached record levels and was running at 7% year on year at the end of March in the Eurozone. Monetary policies are returning to normal, accompanied by raising interest rates plus 0.9% for the German bond 10 years. Yeah, they wrote bond, but it's bond. Lastly, the war in Ukraine will weigh on economic growth in addition to the human tragedy it represents. In this context, Covivio can count on a solid balance sheet with a loan to value of 39%, reduced by 2 points in 2021, 84% of its debt hedged against rising interest rates in 2022, and no need for refinancing within 2 years. Covivio also boasts a diversified business model with well-oriented businesses. Currently experiencing great change, offices are confirming their role as a strategic driver of corporate transformations. With its ability to design and offer new flexible and serviced offices in prime areas, Covivio is meeting its need, as evidenced by the record level of lettings in 2021 and strong activity in the first quarter of 2022. In a market characterized by a severe housing shortage, the residential business in Germany offers robust growth prospects, both through rental reversion, plus 20% on an average, and through the potential of revaluation of assets values, carried at book value in the balance sheets. Yeah, they wrote here block book value in the balance sheet, 30% to 50% below unit values. Lastly, the hotel industry has started to recover, driven by tourism, leisure and business customers, with the need for companies to recreate links with their employees and customers. Growth in RevPAR versus 2019 also demonstrates the business's pricing power. The strong growth in revenues can therefore be expected to continue in the incoming months. But it all depends on the that we have now. We are now, or it seems like we are coming out of this pandemic, and of course the work from home will no longer be in place, and the employees will return to offices, so that will certainly increase the demand for office space. Also, if you are thinking about residential, the demand is always increasing, and especially in the large cities of the large countries, it's only natural. And also, if you are thinking about the tourism at hotels and things like this, there will have to be a revigoration in the next months and years, because let's say that the pandemic affected a lot several sectors of the economy, also in Europe. And yeah, all in all, I'm quite optimistic about the results of these companies. Just as I have said, and you've seen, these are not typical financial state quarter and financial statements, earnings calls, and presentation from the management and discussion with analysts and so on and so forth. But there are just some press releases, which I understand they are also mandatory. They are not in the traditional format that we expect for companies which are listed. And I'm quite happy with my investments in real estate investment trusts, including the Gecina. I just can't wait to buy some Covivio as well. Just as a disclaimer, I'm not a financial analyst. This is no financial advice, meaning that your decisions to buy or sell shares or fund titles, because they are investment funds, are yours and yours alone, and I take no responsibilities in your decision making. If you liked this video, do not forget to hit the like button, share it with somebody that might be interested about REITs in general, French REITs, and these two specific, Gecina and Covivio from France. Comment in the comment section if you have something to add to the topic. But most importantly, do not forget to subscribe to my channel, to hit the bell notification button, and you will never miss an update on my site. I do them quite regularly these days. On Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Sundays, you should expect new and hopefully interesting videos from me. Below this video, you have links. You can create an eToro account and trade there without a commission or a fee, which is always a saving no matter how often you are trading. If you are trading there with your own money, with own shares, if you are trading leverage, you will actually trade CFDs. Just as a disclaimer, never forget that by using eToro or any other brokerage service or bank or whatever you are using, losses are possible, so do not always expect to have infinite gains. Below that link, you have another link with an Amazon wish list with hardware and software items which can help me improve the quality of my videos. That's being beneficial for you because you'll get better videos from me. But let's just be honest and say that from financial perspective, this is the most inconvenient way to support me. The most convenient way for you is to simply subscribe to my channel. It doesn't cost you anything, and if you hit the bell notification button, and you can also watch my videos, and this will be also much appreciated. Once again, my name is Alex Petrescu. This is my Finance and Accounting Education channel here on YouTube. I thank you today for your patience and time, of course, and I look forward to presenting to you with the next opportunity. Goodbye.